beautiful culmination of God's plan. 14th week in Ordinary Time, 9th of July, Friday reflection. God gave Jacob a promise and Joseph a dream. He made it to a completion after an arduous, difficult, terrible journey, of course. But then yet, he has completed it. My dear friends, God promised Jacob when he was in dilemma whether to go to Israel, whether to go to Egypt, because it's a pagan land, because it's a different land. Their promised land is different. But then God spoke to him and said, Jacob, Jacob, here I am. He said, I am God and God of your father. Do not be afraid to go to Egypt, for I will make you into a great nation. And I will go with you to Egypt, and I will bring you back again, and Joseph's hand will close your eyes. All the pain, agony, was brought to beautiful culmination. That's how he works with us. He will send us, but then he will send us not to have a life without struggles. No. It is, humanly speaking, it is terrible times, horrible, incorrigible. That life is difficult. Always it's a narrow path, isn't it? Life with a cross, thorns. But then the Lord is saying, I'm with you. I'm with you. The Lord is saying, see, look, I send you out like sheep among the wolves. I mean, sheep with wolves. What do they have as defense mechanism? Sheep, they can't run fast. Sheep, they can't camouflage. Sheep, they can't fight back. One sheep is completely vulnerable before them, before the wolves. It's only security, the shepherd. Shepherd will lay his life for the sheep. Shepherd will safeguard them. So I will send you, this is the key tone, key word, I will send you. It's Jesus who is sending me. That's where your focus should be Jesus. Your focus should be his word. God is saying, I will send you. Don't be afraid to go to Egypt. I will go with you. I will take you back. You send them and get them back. So this is the journey, isn't it? So that is the assurance that sheep has. So sheep does not have anything innate in itself. Sheep has a strength in the shepherd. So this is the beautiful comparison that when we think about our God's connection with ourselves, the Lord is saying, you must be clever as snakes and innocent as doves. So you can't be relaxed life. No. Be still and know that you're not. Be still and I'm going to fight for you. So be still is a war position where you are ready with all the armor until you get the command. Otherwise you're being still means you're just relax. You sleep, you rest. No, not at all. Be still and know that I'm your Lord. But then your inside is calm, serene. That peace of the shalom in yourself. Be still. The Lord is saying, you must be clever as snakes. So you can't just rest there. You have to be clever. Be still. Be aware that you are amidst snakes. You are amidst wolves. So snakes are always, snakes they can't hear, my dear friends. They can feel the vibration. So they hear the vibration. So they are aware of the slightest change in the vicinity. So that kind of awareness we have to have. Because that will save you, safeguard you. And also, innocent as doves. You will depend on him completely. Dove is a sign of obedience. Moses Nova, send a dove, send a crow. And it didn't ever came back. But then he sent a dove, the dove came back. So it's obedience, it's innocence. You depend on him completely. You're not going to fight because the Lord is going to do the fighting for you. And the word says, be on your guard. We have to have this word today. Be on your guard. Be careful. And the Lord is not saying, be afraid. Now we are, of course, we are afraid. For no sooner we see the wolves, we are afraid. We see the powerful party, we are afraid. No. We are invited to be on our guard. You know, you don't have to be scared. Fear is a very negative thing before God. It's against faith, isn't it? Be on your guard. The Lord will take you. And with respect, with your guard, with respect to people, for they will hand you over to their courts and they will flog you and in their synagogues. You will be brought to trial before rulers and kings because of me, and so you may witness to them and the pagans. So it's an opportunity when you are taken, when you are flogged, when you are judged, condemned. It's an opportunity for you. And the word says, but when you are arrested, do not worry about what you are to say and how you are to say it. When the hour comes, you will be given what you are to say, for it is not you who will speak, but I will be the Spirit of Yahweh. It will be the Spirit of Yahweh, your Father in you. You don't have to worry at all. Just relax like a sheep, because shepherd will do the rest. I mean, just have faith. You don't have to worry looking at the sea, looking at Goliath. No, it can be huge and big. Yet you will have him above all the negative forces. And my dear friends, it's beautiful. Beautiful. The Lord sent Jacob to go to that land. And the word says, brothers will hand over to death a father, his children, and will turn against parents, have them put to death. Brothers will hand over brother to death. This is exactly what happened to Joseph, isn't it? So how their own kith and kin rejected him. But then at last, through him, a great blessing was brought to Israel. That's how he works. That's how he works. When they persecute you in the town, flee to the next. For sure you will not have gone through all the towns of Israel before the Son of Man comes. Every rejection is an opportunity. Every closed door is another opportunity to open doors. So it's an invitation. Take the rejection very positively. So God has planned the finale, completion, in a beautiful way. My dear friends, we find how God, Joseph, got his chariot ready in order to meet Israel, his father, in Goshen. He presented himself, threw his arm around him, his father, and wept on his shoulder for a long time. Israel said to Joseph, now I can die, for I have seen your face and know you are alive. That's how God completes it. If there is no pain, there is no gain. So be not afraid. Depend on him. He will take you through difficult valleys, difficult journey. But then he has planned the finale. He has planned it completely. So every opportunity, every trial, every difficulty is going to be an opportunity. So have faith, be on guard, be aware, rest in him, be still, and know that he is our Lord. Amen. May God bless you.